Hello there. Welcome to Dynamics 365 Bytes. We are starting a new series on business performance analytics. My name is Archana Prasad, and I'm a principal solution architect. The objective of this session is to provide a high-level overview of business performance analytics, aka BPA, with the subsequent sessions focusing on installation, configuration, BPA data model, and extensibility. Before we delve into what is business performance analytics, take a look at the problem statement. Historically, finance teams have spent most of their time running financial operations and creating financial reports and statements and delivering business performance insights, either monthly, quarterly, or yearly. As the speed of business continues to accelerate, finance professionals are being asked to deliver these metrics more frequently and at a micro level. A significant obstacle that hinders the finance professionals or even the business leaders from maximizing the potential of these tools is a need for advanced technical skills to consolidate, manipulate, and integrate data from various disparate systems utilized in business operations. This requires a deep understanding of complex data models and the ability to normalize, transform, and combine data sets to provide a usable output for all business users. This is where BPA provides an intuitive out-of-box data model along with familiar tools like Microsoft Excel and Power BI for self-service analytics. So what is business performance analytics? Data that is extracted from Dynamics 365 is classified in BPA in the form of value chains. And value chains are nothing but a group of business processes. On top of the value chain, we are providing a way to secure data through role-based access control. And on top of that, you can enable purpose-built analytics, insights, and eventually co-pilot capabilities, along with the ability to extend the data into your own fabric. So why BPA? BPA allows you to simplify data insights by providing a unified view of business data across entities in near real time. It allows you to streamline financial reporting and operations to reduce the cycle times. It also provides auditors with direct access to financial data, making the audit process more efficient. In fact, not just auditors, it allows all users of all technical abilities to quickly access and analyze data to facilitate data-driven decisions. And ultimately, it enables ease of use through familiar apps like Excel and Power BI, in addition to AI-driven insights and automation in this platform that can be scalable and extendable. Now, how does BPA work? So the ETL process in BPA involves extracting data from finance and operations database, transforming and loading it into Dataverse. Each of the entities required for the generation of the dimensional model for the value chains that were mentioned earlier, they are backed by the underlying tables in finance and operations database. So once BPA is installed in Dataverse, virtual entities that are created will then pull in the data into the managed data lake. This data is then transformed to generate the dimensional model, which is then pushed into the embedded Power BI workspace in the form of analytical tables. BPA consumes this data from Power BI workspace to render the Power BI reports. This data can also be extended to customers' fabric if there is a need to consolidate data from multiple sources. Let's take a quick peek into license and data-related information for BPA. BPA is included in Dynamics 365 Finance license. Data refreshes currently 2 times a day with unlimited refreshes targeted post-GA. Data volume will be initially for about 8 quarters of data, and extensibility will be supported with Bring Your Own Fabric. For more up-to-date details on data refresh and data volume or any aspects of roadmap, please join the Weba Engage group for business performance analytics. With that, let's take a look at the prerequisites for installing BPA and how to install BPA in the next session.